what the heck is going on in California, particularly San Francisco. I came across this really bizarre story about this charity, Micah, in Orange County. They're actually struggling with the local Santa Ana, actually struggling with the local city government. They're trying to, they're basically just feeding homeless people. Santa Ana, yeah, they're feeding homeless people, and the city's coming after them because they're saying that these people are operating outside of they're using zoning laws to sort of stop these people. And what they're doing, they're giving out IDs, they're helping these homeless people get IDs. So a lot of these people coming out of jail, they're helping them get IDs, they're helping them get hygiene kits, just some basic things they need to actually get on their feet. And the city's giving them trouble because they're also offering food. And so now the Department of Justice is getting involved in this situation. And Micah, there's a Christian organization, charity organization. They're trying to get the Department of Justice involved. They're saying that the city is targeting them and violating their religious rights or religious freedoms. And what type of world do we live in? where city governments are going after. I think the thought behind it is that, oh, if we target the people who are trying to help the homeless people, it won't attract more homeless people there. That's the thinking, because ultimately, when it comes to homelessness, a lot of people just want the problem to get addressed, but away from them. They don't want to be a part of the solution. That's something I notice a lot. But there's still some good people in a lot of communities. I actually worked in a homeless shelter for years. And from my approach, from my perspective, I think you need somebody to actually come in with a number of resources. You got to be prepared to offer them employment. You got to be prepared to offer them mental health treatment. You got to be prepared to offer them substance use disorder treatment. You got to be prepared for all that stuff. Some of these models, some of these programs, the whole idea is that, oh, if we just give them a job, or no, if we just get them employed, the rest of it will take care of itself. That's not really it. Oh, if we just get them housed, that's the main factor. It's not just one factor. There's a lot of different reasons why people end up homeless. And you need to have an array of resources to offer when you are trying to assess what the person really needs. And ultimately, if the person doesn't want to be helped, it's only so much you can do. You need to work with people who, some people just don't want the help, and you got to be able to accept that reality as well. But in San Francisco, Dave Chappelle recently did a comedy show, and he asked a question, and the audience laughed. It's a surprise show. What the F happened to this place? Talking about San Francisco, it's probably talking about the homeless crisis, just the decay of the city, it's just reports we're hearing. Like, for example, this one journalist said that fentanyl and a number of homelessness, a number of things, the city was basically turning into a failed city. That's what he said. I don't even have the name of the journalist, but it's pretty obvious. It's getting so bad at San Francisco, for example, well, Uber in San Francisco, they're actually going to abandon 285,000 square feet of office space. Their staff, they're insisting on working from home. Now, I'm not a big fan of working from home. I think it's just an excuse for some people not to really put forth 100%. But now, when you're asking people to go into an environment that's chaotic and unsafe, I mean, it's kind of hard to argue against it. Apparently, the city is being overrun by homeless encampments. Drugs has become a big issue. This is Uber. They actually invested $160 million into building up this 11-story headquarters. It has enough space for at least 1,500 people. That's what's going on. But you know, it's not all gloom and doom. Joe Biden's coming to the rescue. Hey, look, seriously, the state of California and at least five other major cities, which includes Los Angeles, Dallas, Seattle, Chicago, and Phoenix, they're going to receive some funding from the federal government. And the whole plan is centered around reducing homelessness in those areas by 25% by 2025. I wish them luck. Money is definitely part of the solution, but you need more than just that. You can't just throw money at this situation and think, oh, you're gonna have it resolved. So yeah, homelessness, it's a big problem in this country. It's gonna become an even bigger problem, because I just talked about this in my last video, one of my last videos. A lot of American families are struggling. Around 40% of American family households are struggling to pay for the groceries, just basic home expenses. So you're going to see more and more people homeless. People you would have never thought were homeless are going to end up on the streets. So, and the cost, of everything. The wages aren't keeping up with this extreme cost. I mean, this is one of the big factors right there. So anyway, guys, do your best. Take care of one another. Take care of your family. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. What do you think about the homelessness crisis in San Francisco? It's getting to the point where there's needles on the ground, a common place for needles to be found on the ground, manure, those are the reports. And if you're in San Francisco, tell me what you think. I'm sure a lot of people are moving out because they can't really tolerate that environment. You're going to have commercial space not being rented out, not being leased out. It's going to create a ripple effect. When those offices shut down, all the businesses, or the restaurants that relied on them, relied on all that traffic, that foot traffic, they're going to start to hurt, and they're going to have to shut down as well. It's going to be a big ripple effect. But